Alright, how to make a zombie finger, and it doesn't really matter if you have Play-Doh, what kind of clay you have, we're just gonna, this is gonna be simple, and I'm gonna pretend you don't have any tools, and so I just have a butter knife. Pretty much everyone should have a butter knife, and I don't have any toothpicks, but if you had a toothpick I would use that, but I just have a regular stick. I use Super Sculpey, the original, the beige. It's got a picture of a seahorse on the front. Look at your finger. I'm just gonna kind of form basically that shape-ish. So, you know, I'm gonna roll my thumb in right there. See how I got that shape? And take another joint and pinch it. Just put some pressure on where your nail is. Should dare mess up your tube. Okay, so take your butter knife and I'm gonna just press where I want the edge of the nail, right there. And then the other side. I'm just gonna, so now you should have that. So now I'm just going to roll the butter knife. Roll. If you have the best tools for this is wax making tools. I'm gonna turn my butter knife around, put it on that crevice, push down into the corner. Like when you take the butter knife, and you can practice if you want, push down just on the side, and when you round it, let up on the pressure. You'll have something like that. And then you just take the butter knife, put it towards the bottom, and pull up a few times. Pull up. Kind of shape that nail, get back in that corner and pull up, shape that nail. Okay, if you want to go back through and roll, if you want to get back through there and roll, you can. I'm gonna pinch. I'm going to cut some of this flesh away, lift it up, and then I'm going to add some stripes, and then there's a torn flesh there, and then I'm going to add the bone in there, push in there with the tip of the butter knife, and just make a nice round indent, best you can. Get up under that nail. Just lift all that clay up. Just see for a minute, you know. Just move it around and get in there and make that bone. Okay. I'm just going down and pulling up on the clay, and you can take a paintbrush and smooth down. You can take a paintbrush and smooth down the. But since I'm going to pretend you have no tools, I'm not going to use a paintbrush. And then just. Okay. And then so I'm going to put that flesh. Actually, I'm going to do two-tone flesh. I'm going to get under, see how it's lipped right where my finger is? I'm going to keep my camera up. I'm going to Wish I had a head cam. I'm gonna get under there and double it up, cut it up twice, get under there. See what's like that? Now I'm just gonna push this flesh back down a little bit. Add some more stripes to my nail because I messed it up. Let's see, I'm gonna add some stripes for the knuckles. A couple. I'm gonna go in on the side here, do the same thing. I'm just gonna cut a piece of flesh open. Smooth that out. Don't touch your other one. I'm gonna cut it a little bit more up here. Okay, and then, let's see. What would be cool? Let's do the muscles, okay? If you wanna do a muscle effect. Okay. Take, this is really hard. Take, like, an oval and attach a tail to it. Make like a sperm. See right here? Well, maybe you see there's a sperm shape. And on the sperm shape, make stripes. And then just flatten it. And then, like, add stripes, and then add tails to the stripes. If the stripes have tails, it'll look like muscle. And then just push the flesh that you tore back on her. Just push it on best you can. If you need to tear some of it, tear it, you know. Like, this is probably gonna go. And then just to make it, I'm gonna jag it just to make it look torn and rip it up a little bit. You don't have to do this. You could just be done at this point, but I'm just gonna add a bone sticking out. Just cut some of the tube down and just really round out the corners. Just round out the corners a little bit. Not a lot. If you gotta learn to do this, just pinch. Okay, because if you can just grab and just pinch, just learn to pinch. And pinching will make bones. Take your clay, take two pieces, two little balls, round them up into about that shape. Just pinch, make a tear, you know, just pinch one in so it's nice and thin. And then do the same for this one. Kind of make them, and then stick them together. You can overlap them a touch. Start rolling, and as they roll, kind of separate, pull down kind of, and just pinch it on. Can't really mess it up. Grab another ball, about the size of a rose petal, kind of oval it, just a touch, and then pinch. You just want a nice pinch, and then when you pull it off of your thumb, it should look like that. You can stretch it out a tad. You can roll the leaves if you'd like. And then just kind of bend it to where you'd like and add that on somewhere. Okay, kind of pinch. And you don't even have to do the extra pinching. I'm just doing that because I think I'm superior to my clay. Oops, and see, I pinched that too thin, so I'm gonna turn it upside down. Hope the bottom's okay. The bottom is fine. Pinch it real soft, get a nice round bulbous edge. And then I like to manipulate the clay. And you can even wave it around. Get it to where you want. Anyway, when you're all done, roll at the bottom. And there you go. Sure.